we cannot assume using a CAD tool without mouse, because it is difficult to use any of the CAD tool without the mouse. You need the shifting of the objects, you need object to be rotated, you want to see the other views, you want to zoom, you want to zoom out. So for those operations, every time it is not possible to shift to the toolbar and then apply the operation. Say I will go to the rotate tool, I will activate that, and then I will rotate the object again. I will go to rotate tool, then again activate that, and then rotate the object. It is quite difficult, or it is quite time consuming for me, because in any simple model which I create, at least 100 times I will use these operations. I will either pan, I will either rotate it, or I'll go for zoom in, zoom out. It can be anything. You need the mouse operations to be. So let's have a look at the mouse operations, how exactly mouse and buttons of mouse behaves when you use it on CATIA V5. Before that, what we need is, whenever you use any CAD tool, we need a mouse having three buttons, MB1, MB2 and MB3. This scroll is also required, because in many of the tools it is used for zoom in, zoom out. Similarly in CATIA as well, this MB2, the scroll button, has more importance as compared to the other buttons. So the left hand side button I will call it as MB1, this middle scroll button I will call it as MB2, and third one, right hand side button, will be MB3. Starting with the operations, these are the operations that we perform. Pan, we can rotate, and we can zoom. For panning, it is written that press and hold the middle mouse button and move mouse to pan. How exactly we can do that, I'll show you. Say you can use the view toolbar over here for all the operations, say for panning, for rotating, for zoom in, zoom out. Still we need the mouse. Why? Because it is easy for us. I will just press and I will keep it pressed. So by pressing MB2, I'll not leave the MB2, I'll just keep it pressed, and I will move my mouse, so I will be able to move the particular part I have created. This is your MB2 or pan operation. Next comes rotate. What it is saying, press and hold the middle mouse button, okay, then the left mouse button, and then move your object. I'll do the same. First I will press and hold the middle mouse button, then I will press the left button, and then I will rotate. So using both the buttons, you have to keep both the button as pressed, then you will be able to rotate it. And third case, press and hold the middle mouse button, click the left button, and then leave it. So press and hold MB2, MB1 you have to click and leave, then you will be able to go for zoom in, zoom out. In all three operations, you need MB2 to be there. For the pan operation, your MB2 will be on hold. In rotate operation, MB2 and MB1 both will be on hold. And in zoom in, zoom out, MB2 will be on hold, MB1 you have to just click, and you will be able to do that. This is what mouse operation is. Yes, you can rotate the objects using compass as well. You can drag the compass dynamically, and you can do that as well. This is what all about mouse operation is. Do try this first, make an habit of using the software, and make an habit of doing this operations, pan, rotate and zoom in, zoom out using the mouse only. It will save your time. This was all about your mouse operations. Thank you.